Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you three awesome tips you can use to enhance your vacation photos. 1. If you're using CC 2015 or later, use the dehaze filter to remove haze and increase contrast and color. 2. If you're using CS5 or later, use Photo Merge to seamlessly merge multiple photos into one image. And 3. If you're using CS6 or later, use Statistics Script in the stack mode to remove tourists and unwanted moving objects automatically. For your convenience, I provided all the photos that I'm using in this video so you can follow along. Their links are in my video's description below or project files. If you'd like to use your own photos instead, feel free to open them. Before we begin, if you're not already a subscriber to my channel, click my logo at the lower right corner or the link in my video's description below. We'll start with the dehaze filter. First, convert the photo into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. To do this, click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Go to Filter and Camera Raw Filter. To fit the Camera Raw Filter window onto your canvas, click this icon. On the right-hand side, you'll see a row of icons. If you're using Photoshop version CC 2015.5 or later, click this icon, which opens the Basic Settings panel. The dehaze filter is located here. However, if you're using Photoshop version CC 2015, you'll notice that there's no dehaze. No problem. Click the FX icon. The dehaze filter is located at the top of this panel. If you want to remove all the haze, drag the dehaze slider all the way to the right. You can also adjust the other settings in the basic panel. Keep in mind, since every photo has its own unique characteristics, feel free to experiment with the other basic settings for each of your photos. The Photo Merge command combines several photographs into one continuous image. Before you snap the photos, there are a few things you should know to get the best results. Images should overlap by approximately 20%. If you use a zoom lens, don't zoom in or out while taking your pictures. Keep the camera level and stay in the same position so that the pictures are from the same viewpoint. If you can use a tripod, so much the better. Maintain the same exposure. Some digital cameras change exposure settings automatically as you take pictures, so you may need to check your camera's settings to be sure that all the images have the same exposure. Lastly, avoid using the flash in some pictures and not in others. Once you download your photos, place them all into a folder and make sure the folder is easily accessible. Go to File, Automate, and Photo Merge. Under Source Files, click Folder. This uses all the images stored in a folder to create the Photo Merge composition. Click the Browse button and locate and click the folder. Immediately, your photos will populate the source files list. There are 6 different layouts from which you can choose to merge your photos. Feel free to experiment with all the layouts. For this example, I'll tick spherical. I'll check blend images together, geometric distortion, and content-aware fill transparent areas. Photo Merge is now finding overlapping sections of the photos, seamlessly merging them, removing distortion, and filling transparent areas with similar image content nearby. The areas that have selections around them would have been transparent if content-aware fill wasn't checked. To deselect it, press Ctrl or Command D. To crop your image, open your Rectangular Marquee tool and drag a selection over your image to how you'd like it cropped. Go to Image and Crop. Then, deselect it. If you ever wanted to shoot a scene, but it was always filled with tourists or unwanted moving objects, well, this third tip will show you how to remove them. The same rules apply that I explained for merging your photos. This time, shoot at least a half dozen to 20 shots, waiting at least 20 to 30 seconds between each shot to give tourists and moving objects enough time to move away from their present positions in each photo. If you're not using a tripod, make sure you stand in the same position and hold your camera at the same height and as steady as possible. Place all of your photos into a folder and go to File, Scripts, and Statistics. Click Median for the stack mode and locate and open the folder in which you've placed your photos. The photos immediately populate the list of source files. Make sure Attempt to Automatically Align Source Images is checked. This is essential if you've shot your photos without a tripod. Click OK, and Photoshop will begin the alignment and the disappearing process. And when finished, the photo will open up inside of Photoshop as a single layered document. Odds are the previous step will remove most, if not all, of the people from your image. However, there may be some tourists who are not fully removed. This is probably because they didn't walk around enough throughout your images, so they were seen as part of the landscape. There are many ways to remove these apparitions, including the clone stamp tool and the healing brush tools. You can also use content-aware fill. Since these tools don't work on smart objects, we'll make a composite snapshot of our image. First, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Press Alt-Control-Shift-E on Windows or Option-Command-Shift-E on a Mac. Open your Lasso tool and make sure the Add To icon is active. This allows you to add selections as you draw them. Draw a tight selection around the empty areas near the borders, as well as any tourists that remain in your image. Go to Edit and Fill. Choose Content Aware, then deselect it. If my tutorials have helped you learn or improve in Photoshop, please consider supporting my channel by becoming a patron on Patreon. For as little as $2 per month, you not only help keep my tutorials free, you'll also be able to watch my new tutorials 1 week before anyone else can see them on YouTube. Click the Patreon button at the top corner or the link in my video's description. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.